Welcome to the Marcus White Show. Let's talk about this
Hello,
trans getting killed for giving head. Let's
Marcus
lotion
White
up.
Show is 10 o'clock or 11. Oh my god. Today is the 12th. First of all, check out my hair vlog. I am gonna cut my hair. Every 15 days, so like the 15th middle and then dye it again because I see some new growth. So yeah. Yeah, this is my weight loss journey. Okay, so it's 172. You got a, I don't get why it's... I'm going... Thinking about eating again. 171. It's 171. So when... I'm just losing weight. Let me just keep going. I'm Joshua Mayo. I wish you were here. Gave me his telegram. But he's still talking about the... I'm trying to be friends. He's still talking about making money. I'm not spending money to make money. Whoever made this thing came from hell. You do not spend money to make money. You just have money. You know why? Because you're supposed to have morals. If you think you're supposed to be an asshole. No. So when on Telegram, he asked me the same questions he asked in the email. So Oprah's passed the torch to Sherry Shepherd. Hold up. Watch this. Pastor Torch to Sherry Shepherd. I have a cut right here. Fuck you. And also, fucking eight.
Yes, you all know what's about to come because of the title. And also, before I start this story, I want to send a special shout out to my cousin Tay Tay. Also, for sending this story.
I already did this one thing. I have a cut right here.
to tell you all that he will be on the market very soon, but not for the women, for the men, or what he called fish baskets. Now, this story right here really intrigues me.
And it's very sad what happened to this person. Oh, no. Oh, no.
I'm awesome.
Oh no, everybody, we need to start charging. He talking about the man, the garbage guy. Yes. Who's Journey Sullivan?
Yeah,
I think it's Journey Sullivan. Brother is gay. Making like this disgusting.
Big shout out to all the channel members and subscribers
of the Trade. Go to the hospital and see if they will treat you.
Each and every last one of you all. Mm. You all, we have a story out of Minnesota, out of Minneapolis. And big shout out to everybody, great state of Minnesota. Everybody, it's out of the great city of Minneapolis. Now, before I start this story, I want to send a special thank you all to my channel members and also to my subscribers for sending me this story. And also, keep these stories coming. And also,
yo.
Yes, you all know what's about to come because of the title. And also, before I start this story, I want to send a special shout out to my cousin Tay Tay also for sending me the story. Y'all already know my cousin Tay Tay, yes. Tay Tay is hella gay. And Tay Tay told me to tell you all that he will be on the market very soon.
He hella good. He hella good.
Or what he called fish baskets. Now, this story right here really intrigues me. And it's very sad what happened to this person. But I am still left bewildered. I am also still left confused and a little suspicious of my damn self. And also, by now, I'm sure that a lot of you all have heard about the story, but if you ain't prepared to hold on to your panties and your drawers, because it's about to get real hot up in here. But anyway, as you all know, today is not Thirsty Thursday. Yes, today is Messy Monday, and it's going to be some mess today. So what I need you all to do right now is get those sweet, precious, badass kids out the room right now so we can see what's really going on in Minnesota, inside the mind of, yes, the Martin Kalon Bible. And with a name like Bible, sir. If you would have had a Bible in your hand, we wouldn't even be at this point right now. Anyway, get those kids out the front. Go ahead. But anyway, hopefully those kids are out the room by now. If those kids are not out the room by now, tough, double D did it. And since today is Messy Monday, yes, all sides matter. Come as you are. Now, the story goes that DeMaria Kalon Bible was walking through a courtyard, I guess through his apartment complex, and he happened to come across Savannah Ryan Williams around 5 in the morning. Now, as I did my research, it was like 27 degrees in Minneapolis, Minnesota, during the time that this killing took place. So, sir, DeMarion, why was you out there early in the morning unless you were taking your butt to work? And clearly, you weren't out there trying to go to work. You was doing what we call, yes, head hunting. You was hunting for some head. Now, DeMarion wants us to think that he did not know that this was a man. So let me ask you all right now, because we're going to get this point started right. Look at this picture. And no disrespect to the dead. But sir, how in the hell did you not know this was a man? And now I'm going to ask you all out there, the viewers, the men and the women, can you not look and tell if it's a man? Does this look like a woman or a man you? So please answer that for me in the coming session. Now, DeMarion, so sir, DeMarion, why was you out there early in the morning?
What is going on? I'm pressing that. I'm pressing that. Okay, I'm trying to get what he's talking about happened. No, please. It's gracious. Minnesota. If you push
please
me on for
that. Session. Now,
what is the what is the thing in there? Oh my god, I can't hear it.
Because it's about to get real hot up in here. But anyway, as you all know, today is not Thursday. Yes, today is Messy Monday. And it's going to be some mess today. So what I need you all to do right now is get those sweet, precious, badass kids out the room right now so we can see what's really going on in Minnesota inside the mind of, yes, DeMarion Kalon Bible. And with a name like Bible, sir, if you would have had a Bible in your hand, we wouldn't even be at this point right now. Anyway, get those kids out the room. Go ahead. But anyway, hope those kids are out the room by now. If those kids are not out the room by now, tough, double D did it. And since today is Messy Monday, yes, all sides matter. Come as you are. Now, the story goes that DeMaria Kalon Bible was walking through a courtyard, I guess through his apartment complex, and he happened to come across Savannah Ryan Williams around 5 in the morning. Now, as I did my research, it was like 27 degrees in Minneapolis, Minnesota, during the time that this killing took place. So, sir, DeMaria, why was you out there early in the morning unless you were taking your butt to work? And clearly, you weren't out there trying to go to work. You was doing what we call, yes, head hunting. You was hunting for some head. Now, DeMarion wants us to think that he did not know that this was a man. So let me ask you all right now, because we're going to get this point sorted right. Look at this picture. And no disrespect to the dead.
He was hunting for some head.
How in the hell did you not know this was a man? And now I'm going to ask you all out there, the viewers, the men and the women, can you not look at Jalen as a man does, just like a woman or a man with you? So, please answer that for me in the coming session. Now, DeMaria said that Savannah Ryan Williams asked him if he wanted to have sex. And guess what this numbnut did? He said yes. Didn't even know the person. Like, look, how the hell you going to sit up here and just meet somebody? You walking by, allegedly, and somebody in the hall say you want to have sex, and you're like, yeah. Talk about not using protection and using common sense. Who in the hell have sex just like that, that damn fast? After DeMorgan agreed to have sex with Savannah Ryan Williams, they immediately left swiftly and went to a courtyard where Savannah Ryan Williams performed oral sex on DeMorgan. And DeMorgan said during this encounter with Savannah Ryan Williams that he felt suspicious several times. Now I'm going to tell you all this right here. Look here. If you are doing something and you feel suspicious about it, chances are, guess what? You need to stop what you're doing, or you need to check and see what it is you're really doing. Now, how the hell can you become suspicious of somebody and not even check and see what's really going on? It sounded like to me DeMario was more interested in busting a nut than finding out, was this a real woman? I believe he already knew it was a damn man. So anyway, now DeMario did not pull out. He did not stop Savannah Ryan Williams. What he did was waited, yes, till he got that nut, and then he shot Savannah Ryan Williams in the head.
Whoa.
Damn shame, point blank range. Now, DeMarion is facing 40 years in jail, raising hell. He can't make bail. But guess what? His dad is not going to come get him out. And DeMarion, dad, if you see this video,
he's
in jail. Because guess what? With the last name Bible, he disrespected the whole damn family legacy. How the hell you out here doing this type of stuff? You got a holy name. So let's think about that for a second. Who in the hell have the last name Bible and out here getting popped off by men and then want to kill a man after you bust up? That's a damn shame. I mean, golly, talk about not being grateful or thankful. Now, it's hard to believe that DeMarion was tricked because, like I told y'all in the beginning of the video, look at this person. How can you not look and tell that's a damn man? Look at the head. Look at the shoulders. I mean, the shoulders big as a damn football player or linebacker. And once again, no disrespect. Now, we'll break the rest down as I read a snippet from this story. I'm going to read a quick snippet from this story, and I am going to give my opinion. I'll look. Surely, as we go. Man whose last name is Bible fatally shot transgender woman who made him feel suspicious doing oral sex, says the cops. So I don't want nobody to sit up here saying that I'm lying, make up these stories. No, we get the story straight from the horse's mouth. It also, this correlates to the last video I did just Friday, where we had a transgender that was inside of a hotel allegedly tricking a man into coming to the room having sex with him. Now, the person stated in that video that I don't think he knows.
I don't think he knows
that I'm really a man and tricked this guy allegedly. The video is already out for those who have not seen that video. Anyway, be careful of what you're doing out here because you just never know what you're getting yourself into. Now let's continue. A transgender woman was shot and killed from point blank range by a man to whom she had given oral sex to, says the Minnesota Police Department. And also, somebody got mad at me in my last video saying Trey, you're a part of a problem telling these men and women. No, I'm reading a damn story. I mean, come on now. Let's just be for real. Now I'm part of a problem. You must have watched this damn
show.
You already
know
what I stand for. And like that song said,
okay,
if you
so
don't
yeah.
Now, guess what? You would never.
I'm going to stop here. Ever. I'm going to eat again. I don't get why, but no, I'm not. No, I'm not. I'm a fool. See you guys next time. Oh my god. Like, comment, subscribe. Push the notification bell, stay hydrated. Eat greens. I am 171. I'm trying to get to 168 in the victory dance. Oh, I almost hit 69. Oh my god. So, yeah. See you tomorrow. See you Tuesday.